Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of a virtual appliance, guys. Okay, yes. So basically, in simple words, you can say virtual appliance is a combination or is a version of a virtual machine with an application on it. So basically, with application, it is nothing but virtual appliance. Okay, virtual appliance is a pre-configured virtual machine. I told you, right? So pre-configured virtual machine ready to run on an hypervisor. Okay, so installation of a software appliance on a virtual machine and packaging that into an image creates you the virtual appliance. So basically, with the image, with application, is nothing but your virtual appliance, guys, in simple words. Got it? Yes. So it indirectly contains the application. Got it? Yes. So you can just draw the diagrams in this way. So virtual machine will contain hardware, virtualized layer, operating system and application, whereas virtual appliance contains the virtual application or appliance with virtualized layer and hardware. Okay, so these are some architecture diagram, you can say. Okay, yes. So the main thing that you should observe here is, so for running a virtual machine, you need an operating system, guys. Whereas to run a virtual appliance, there is no requirement of additional operating system, because a small version of that operating system is existing in this virtual appliance only. Got it? Yes. Okay, so that's what the first point says. It contains full OS and it contains part of the OS in itself. Okay, so it may or may not contain application, but it should contain application. So basically, we run the application, guys. Okay, yes. So basically, these virtual appliances will be of these format, guys. OVF format files, they say. Okay, so all files of virtual appliances are OVF format. Okay, yes. So the full form of OVF is nothing but open virtualization format. Okay, so it is approved by ISO and it's an open source standard. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about this concept of a virtual appliance, right? Yes. So in the next lecture, let us go through some introduction about the migration into cloud. So how you migrate from one cloud to another cloud. So do you check anything? Do you do some tests and everything? So we'll be discussing about that in the next lecture. Okay, thank you. Thanks for watching.